Autonomous weapon systems have the capability of deciding to kill without humans involved.
No human intervention at all. It will select that target and engage that target.
This is no longer some sort of distant future science fiction scenario. It's actually right now.
The Pentagon has announced a new initiative to use this technology.
There are so many developments, it's hard to, you know, even keep track.
The window is getting smaller and smaller to stop proliferation.
This is an inflection point for humanity.
It forebodes grave consequences of the future of life if it is not regulated.
In 2017, the Future of Life Institute's Slaughterbots video warned the world of what was to come. That future is now here. In September 2023, the United States announced the Replicator Initiative, a plan to acquire and unleash small autonomous weapons at the scale of multiple thousands in areas such as the South China Sea. These systems are designed to replace humans.
The idea of a machine that functions without human judgment to pull the trigger to kill human beings, that idea itself is quite repugnant.
Then there are legal concerns. Who do we hold accountable? If there are war crimes, if there was an error, algorithms make mistakes.
Trying to build systems that will interpret human behavior and classify humans into combatants or non-combatants is futile. You have a huge amount of complexity and ambiguity, and that is exactly what automated systems are very bad at dealing with.
International humanitarian law means assessment of proportionality. It means to be able to distinguish between civilians and combatants. It means to take feasible precautions in attack. The human role is absolutely essential in making these assessments.
You have here a weapon that allows you on a massive scale to identify targets on the basis of their race, ethnicity, occupation. Autonomous weapon system will empower and enable genocide the world over. The prevention of any kind of weapons, allowing the targeting on the basis of those human characteristics, is absolutely essential.
Condanneremo l'umanità a un futuro senza speranza se sottotraessimo alle persone la capacità di decidere su loro stesse e sulla loro vita, condannandole a dipendere dalle scelte delle macchine.
I think it's highly likely that at some point we would see an inadvertent attack by an autonomous weapon. You know, during the Cuban Missile Crisis, you almost had nuclear jets taking off because a grizzly bear climbed over a fence in Minnesota. And this is even without the addition of a lot of complicated software, which is hard to understand or impossible to understand if you're using these black box ML components. And it's on a hair trigger.
We do know what flash crashes are. We've seen them on the financial markets.
All of a sudden here, we started hearing screaming.
Those algorithms interacting with their environment in unforeseen and unintentional ways. And then, you know, stocks plummeting.
The Dow Jones Industrial Average dropped more than 900 points.
We could get into, you know, basically an algorithmically triggered shooting war that no human intended to take place. You know, some people say that is what needs to happen first before we come to our senses. I hope we're smarter than this. I hope we can, you know, converge on regulations before something bad happens.
We are in the beginnings of an autonomous weapons arms race. States know what needs to be done. They're talking about a potential treaty.
What we've seen in this conference in Vienna today is global solidarity. A majority of the member states of the world are here present, and I believe the majority of the nations of the world will support this call for a legally binding instrument.
The position of the ICSC is that autonomous weapons should be regulated and two types of autonomous weapon systems should be prohibited. The first one are unpredictable ones. Secondly, weapons designed to target people.
The international community is clearly against the unregulated development and deployment of autonomous weapons. Although we have much work ahead of us, Costa Rica has complete confidence in the community gathered here to achieve it.
If we all agree that we don't want to live in a world where algorithms decide to kill people, we have what we need to move forward.
We've got a two-pronged approach. We have a prohibitive part where we're saying, don't build weapons that we can't control. Duh. And all the other weapons, all we need to, you know, guarantee is that there's meaningful human control in the human-machine relationship. Basically, that's the framework for how we can solve this. Now it's about actually acting upon that. That's been hard even before the Russian war in Ukraine and then the Israel-Gaza war. Now it's gotten even harder to get people to move on this.
Unfortunately, there are some countries who don't really seem to be interested in moving forward with regulation. The challenge is to move forward as inclusively as possible without letting a few stymie the whole process.
When we look to history, humans have acted to safeguard humanity at very adversarial times. During the Cold War, we produced treaties on biological and chemical weapons. And at the time, a lot of people said that's impossible. We need these weapons for deterrence or to stay safe. But the world realized that they presented tremendous risks.
Geopolitics is bad, but it's not the reason not to make progress. It's precisely because of geopolitics that we have to desperately try to make as much progress as possible.
Sierra Leone has its own experience of civil conflict. We don't want AI and the autonomous weapon system to also land in the hands of deleterious non-state actors such as terrorists and armed traffickers and warlords.
Stepping out of an arms race requires courage and foresight. We have done it before, and we can do it again.
It's important to realize that you can defend yourself against autonomous weapons without possessing them, just like we have countermeasures for biological and chemical weapons.
The Secretary General has taken a very clear position. He has been actually saying that this idea of a fully autonomous weapon, it's morally repugnant and it should be prohibited by international law. And very soon, the Secretary General said 2026, it is really a sense of urgency that we all have. Let's do the work quickly, because this is really about protecting all of us.